Section 13 of Dramatized Passages from the Old Testament. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. The Story of David, Part 1. From 1 Samuel, Chapters 17 to 20, King James Version. Narrated by Beth Thomas.
David, read by Levi Throckmorton.
Goliath, read by David Lotus.
Jesse,
read by Trotza.
Men of Israel, servants, read by Catherine.
Saul, read by Larry Wilson.
Eliab, read by Delphi Fingerolis.
Abner, read by Thomas Peter.
Women, read by Lydia.
Jonathan, read by Marianne.
Michal, read by Esterman Simonides.
Now the Philistines gathered together their armies to battle, and were gathered together at Shokok, which belongeth to Judah, and pitched between Shokok and Azekah in Ephesdamim. And Saul and the men of Israel were gathered together, and pitched by the valley of Elah, and set the battle in array against the Philistines. And the Philistines stood on a mountain on the one side, and Israel stood on a mountain on the other side, and there was a valley between them. And there went out a champion out of the camp of the Philistines, named Goliath of Gath, whose height was 6 cubits and a span. And he had an helmet of brass upon his head, and he was armed with a coat of mail, and the weight of the coat was 5,000 shekels of brass. And he had greaves of brass upon his legs, and a target of brass between his shoulders. And the staff of his spear was like a weaver's beam, and his spear's head weighed 600 shekels of iron, and one bearing a shield went before him. And he stood and cried unto the armies of Israel, and said unto them,
Why are ye come out to set your battle in array? Am not I Philistine, and ye servants to Saul? Choose you a man for you, and let him come down to me. If he be able to fight with me, and to kill me, then will we be your servants. But if I prevail against him, and kill him, then shall ye be our servants, and serve us.
And the Philistine said,
I defy the armies of Israel this day. Give me a man, that we may fight together.
When Saul and all Israel heard those words of the Philistine, they were dismayed and greatly afraid. Now David was the son of that Ephrathite of Bethlehem Judah, whose name was Jesse, and he had 8 sons. And the man went among men for an old man in the days of Saul. And the 3 eldest sons of Jesse went and followed Saul to the battle. And the names of his 3 sons that went to the battle were Eliab the firstborn, and next unto him Abinadab, and the 3rd Shammah. And David was the youngest, and the 3 eldest followed Saul. But David went and returned from Saul to feed his father's sheep at Bethlehem. And the Philistine drew near morning and evening, and presented himself 40 days. And Jesse said unto David his son,
Take now for thy brethren an ephah of this parched corn, and these 10 loaves, and run to the camp of thy brethren, and carry these 10 cheeses unto the captain of their 1,000, and look how thy brethren fare, and take their pledge.
Now Saul and they and all the men of Israel were in the valley of Elah, fighting with the Philistines. And David rose up early in the morning, and left the sheep with a keeper, and took and went as Jesse had commanded him. And he came to the trench, as the host was going forth to the fight, and shouted for the battle. For Israel and the Philistines had put the battle in array, army against army. And David left his carriage in the hand of the keeper of the carriage, and ran into the army, and came and saluted his brethren. And as he talked with them, behold, there came up the champion, the Philistine of Gath, Goliath by name, out of the armies of the Philistines, and spake according to the same words, and David heard them. And all the men of Israel, when they saw the man, fled from him, and were sore afraid. And the men of Israel said,
Have you seen this man that is come up? Surely to defy Israel is he come up, and it shall be that the man who killeth him, the king will enrich him with great riches, and will give him his daughter, and make his father's house free in Israel.
And David spake to the men that stood by him, saying,
What shall be done to the man that killeth this Philistine, and taketh away the reproach from Israel? For who is this uncircumcised Philistine, that he should defy the armies of the living God?
And the people answered him after this manner, saying,
So shall it be done to the man that killeth him.
And Eliab, his eldest brother, heard when he spake unto the men. And Eliab's anger was kindled against David, and he said,
Why camest thou down hither? And with whom hast thou left those few sheep in the wilderness? I know thy pride, and the naughtiness of thine heart, for thou art come down that thou mightest see the battle.
And David said,
What have I now done? Is there not a cause?
And he turned from him toward another, and spake after the same manner. And the people answered him again after the former manner. And when the words were heard which David spake, they rehearsed them before Saul, and he sent for him. And David said to Saul,
Let no man's heart fail because of him. Thy servant will go and fight with this Philistine.
And Saul said to David,
Thou art not able to go against this Philistine to fight with him, for thou art but a youth, and he a man of war from his youth.
And David said unto Saul,
Thy servant kept his father's sheep, and there came a lion and a bear, and took a lamb out of the flock. And I went out after him, and smote him, and delivered it out of his mouth. And when he arose against me, I caught him by his beard, and smote him, and slew him. Thy servant slew both the lion and the bear, and this uncircumcised Philistine shall be as one of them, seeing he hath defied the armies of the living God.
David said moreover,
The Lord, that delivered me out of the paw of the lion and out of the paw of the bear, he will deliver me out of the hand of this Philistine.
And Saul said unto David,
Go, and the Lord be with thee.
And Saul armed David with his armour, and he put an helmet of brass upon his head. Also he armed him with a coat of mail. And David girded his sword upon his armour, and he assayed to go, for he had not proved it. And David said unto Saul,
I cannot go with these, for I have not proved them.
And David put them off him, and he took his staff in his hand, and chose him 5 smooth stones out of the brook, and put them in a shepherd's bag which he had, even in a scrip. And his sling was in his hand, and he drew near to the Philistine. And the Philistine came on, and drew near unto David, and the man that bare the shield went before him. And when the Philistine looked about, and saw David, he disdained him, for he was but a youth, and ruddy, and of a fair countenance. And the Philistine said unto David,
Am I a dog, that thou comest to me with staves?
And the Philistine cursed David by his gods. And the Philistine said to David,
Come to me, and I will give thy flesh unto the fowls of the air, and to the beasts of the field.
Then said David to the Philistine,
Thou comest to me with a sword, and with a spear, and with a shield, but I come to thee in the name of the Lord of hosts, the God of the armies of Israel, whom thou hast defied. This day will the Lord deliver thee into mine hand, and I will smite thee, and take thine head from thee, and I will give the carcasses of the host of the Philistines this day unto the fowls of the air, and to the wild beasts of the earth, that all the earth may know that there is a God in Israel. And all this assembly shall know that the Lord saveth not with sword and spear, for the battle is the Lord's, and he will give you into our hands.
And it came to pass, when the Philistine arose and came and drew nigh to meet David, that David hastened and ran toward the army to meet the Philistine. And David put his hand in his bag, and took thence a stone, and slung it, and smote the Philistine in his forehead, that the stone sunk into his forehead, and he fell upon his face to the earth. So David prevailed over the Philistine with a sling and with a stone, and smote the Philistine, and slew him. But there was no sword in the hand of David. Therefore David ran, and stood upon the Philistine, and took his sword, and drew it out of the sheath thereof, and slew him, and cut off his head therewith. And when the Philistines saw their champion was dead, they fled. And the men of Israel and of Judah arose and shouted, and pursued the Philistines, until they came to the valley, and to the gates of Ekron. And the wounded of the Philistines fell down by the way to Sharaim, even unto Gath, and unto Ekron. And the children of Israel returned from chasing after the Philistines, and they spoiled their tents. And David took the head of the Philistine and brought it to Jerusalem, but he put his armour in his tent. And when Saul saw David go forth against the Philistine, he said unto Abner, the captain of the host,
Abner, whose son is this youth?
And Abner said,
As thy soul liveth, O king, I cannot tell.
And the king said,
Inquire thou whose son the stripling is.
And as David returned from the slaughter of the Philistine, Abner took him and brought him before Saul, with the head of the Philistine in his hand. And Saul said to him,
Whose son art thou, thou young man?
And David answered,
I am the son of thy servant Jesse the Bethlehemite.
And it came to pass, when he had made an end of speaking unto Saul, that the soul of Jonathan was knit with the soul of David, and Jonathan loved him as his own soul. And Saul took him that day, and would let him go no more home to his father's house. Then Jonathan and David made a covenant, because he loved him as his own soul. And Jonathan stripped himself of the robe that was upon him, and gave it to David, and his garments, even to his sword, and to his bow, and to his girdle. And David went out, whithersoever Saul sent him, and behaved himself wisely. And Saul set him over the men of war, and he was accepted in the sight of all the people, and also in the sight of Saul's servants. And it came to pass, as they came when David was returned from the slaughter of the Philistine, that the women came out of all the cities of Israel, singing and dancing, to meet King Saul with tabrets, with joy, and with instruments of music. And the women answered one another as they played, and said,
Saul hath slain his thousands, and David his 10,000s.
And Saul was very wroth, and the saying displeased him, and he said,
They have ascribed unto David 10,000s, and to me they have ascribed but thousands, and what can he have more but the kingdom?
And Saul eyed David from that day and forward. And it came to pass on the morrow that the evil spirit from God came upon Saul, and he prophesied in the midst of the house. And David played with his hand as at other times, and there was a javelin in Saul's hand. And Saul cast the javelin, for he said,
I will smite David even to the wall with it.
And David avoided out of his presence twice. And Saul was afraid of David, because the Lord was with him, and was departed from Saul. Therefore Saul removed him from him, and made him his captain over 1,000. And he went out and came in before the people. And David behaved himself wisely in all his ways, and the Lord was with him. Wherefore, when Saul saw that he behaved himself wisely, he was afraid of him. But all Israel and Judah loved David, because he went out and came in before them. And Saul said to David,
Behold my elder daughter Merab, her will I give thee to wife. Only be thou valiant for me, and fight the Lord's battles.
For Saul said,
Let not mine hand be upon him, but let the hand of the Philistines be upon him.
And David said unto Saul,
Who am I, and what is my life, or my father's family in Israel, that I should be son-in-law to the king?
But it came to pass, at the time when Merab, Saul's daughter, should have been given to David, that she was given unto Adriel the Meholathite to wife. And Michal, Saul's daughter, loved David, and they told Saul, and the thing pleased him. And Saul said,
I will give him her, that she may be a snare to him, and that the hand of the Philistines may be against him.
Wherefore Saul said to David,
Thou shalt this day be my son-in-law in the one of the twain.
And Saul commanded his servants, saying,
Commune with David secretly, and say, Behold, the king hath delight in thee, and all his servants love thee. Now therefore be the king's son-in-law.
And Saul's servants spake these words in the ears of David. And David said,
Seemeth it to you a light thing to be a king's son-in-law, seeing that I am a poor man and lightly esteemed?
And the servants of Saul told him, saying,
On this manner spake David.
And Saul said,
Thus shall ye say to David, The king desireth not any dowry, but 100 foreskins of the Philistines to be avenged of the king's enemies.
But Saul thought to make David fall by the hand of the Philistines. And when his servants told David these words, it pleased David well to be the king's son-in-law, and the days were not expired. Wherefore David arose and went, he and his men, and slew of the Philistines 200 men. And David brought their foreskins, and gave them in full tale to the king, that he might be the king's son-in-law. And Saul gave him Michal, his daughter, to wife. And Saul saw, and knew that the Lord was with David, and that Michal, Saul's daughter, loved him. And Saul was yet more afraid of David, and Saul became David's enemy continually. Then the princes of the Philistines went forth, And it came to pass, after they went forth, that David behaved himself more wisely than all the servants of Saul, so that his name was much set by. And Saul spake to Jonathan his son, and to all his servants, that they should kill David. But Jonathan, Saul's son, delighted much in David. And Jonathan told David, saying,
Saul, my father, seeketh to kill thee. Now therefore, I pray thee, take heed to thyself until the morning, and abide in a secret place, and hide thyself. And I will go out and stand beside my father in the field where thou art, and I will commune with my father of thee. And what I see, I will tell thee.
And Jonathan spake good of David unto Saul his father, and said unto him,
Let not the king sin against his servant, against David, because he hath not sinned against thee, and because his works have been to thee ward very good. For he did put his life in his hand, and slew the Philistine, and the Lord wrought a great salvation for all Israel. Thou sawest it, and did rejoice. Wherefore then wilt thou sin against innocent blood, to slay David without a cause?
And Saul hearkened unto the voice of Jonathan, and Saul sware,
As the Lord liveth, he shall not be slain.
And Jonathan called David, and Jonathan showed him all these things. And Jonathan brought David to Saul, and he was in his presence as in times past. And there was war again, and David went out and fought with the Philistines, and slew them with a great slaughter, and they fled from him. And the evil spirit from the Lord was upon Saul, as he sat in his house with his javelin in his hand, and David played with his hand. And Saul sought to smite David even to the wall with the javelin, but he slipped away out of Saul's presence, and he smote the javelin into the wall. And David fled, and escaped that night. Saul also sent messengers unto David's house, to watch him and to slay him in the morning. And Michal, David's wife, told him, saying,
If thou save not thy life tonight, tomorrow thou shalt be slain.
So Michal let David down through a window, and he went and fled and escaped. And Michal took an image, and laid it in the bed, and put a pillow of goat's hair for his bolster, and covered it with a cloth. And when Saul sent messengers to take David, she said,
He is sick.
And Saul sent the messengers again to see David, saying,
Bring him up to me in the bed, that I may slay him.
And when the messengers were come in, behold, there was an image in the bed, with a pillow of goat's hair for his bolster. And Saul said unto Michal,
Why hast thou deceived me so, and sent away mine enemy, that he is escaped?
And Michal answered Saul,
He said unto me, Let me go, why should I kill thee?
So David fled, and escaped, and came to Samuel in Ramah, and told him all that Saul had done to him. And he and Samuel went and dwelt in Naioth. And it was told Saul, saying,
Behold, David is at Naioth in Ramah.
And Saul sent messengers to take David. And when they saw the company of the prophets prophesying, and Samuel standing as appointed over them, the Spirit of God was upon the messengers of Saul, and they also prophesied. And when it was told Saul, he sent other messengers, and they prophesied likewise. And Saul sent messengers again the third time, and they prophesied also. Then went he also to Ramah, and came to a great well that is in Sechu, and he asked and said,
Where are Samuel and David?
And one said,
Behold, they be at Naioth in Ramah.
And he went thither to Naioth in Ramah. And the Spirit of God was upon him also. And he went on and prophesied, until he came to Naioth in Ramah. And he stripped off his clothes also, and prophesied before Samuel in like manner, and lay down naked all that day and all that night. Wherefore, they say,
Is Saul also among the prophets?
And David fled from Naioth in Ramah, and came and said before Jonathan,
What have I done? What is mine iniquity? And what is my sin before thy father, that he seeketh my life?
And he said unto him,
God forbid, thou shalt not die. Behold, my father will do nothing, either great or small, but that he will show it me. And why should my father hide this thing from me? It is not so.
And David sware moreover, and said,
Thy father certainly knoweth that I have found grace in thine eyes. And he saith, Let not Jonathan know this, lest he be grieved. But truly, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, there is but a step between me and death.
Then said Jonathan unto David,
Whatsoever thou soul desirest, I will even do it for thee.
And David said unto Jonathan,
Behold, tomorrow is the new moon, and I should not fail to sit with the king at meat. But let me go, that I may hide myself in the field unto the third day at even. If thy father at all miss me, then say, David earnestly asked leave of me that he might run to Bethlehem his city, for there is a yearly sacrifice there for all the family. If he say thus, it is well, thy servant shall have peace. But if he be very wroth, then be sure that evil is determined by him. Therefore thou shalt deal kindly with thy servant, for thou hast brought thy servant into a covenant of the Lord with thee. Notwithstanding, if there be in me iniquity, slay me thyself, for why shouldst thou bring me to thy father?
And Jonathan said,
Far be it from thee, for if I knew certainly that evil were determined by my father to come upon thee, then would I not tell it thee?
Then said David to Jonathan,
Who shall tell me, or what, if thy father answer thee roughly?
And Jonathan said unto David,
Come, and let us go out into the field.
And they went out, both of them, into the field. And Jonathan said unto David,
O Lord God of Israel, when I have sounded my father about tomorrow, or any time, or the third day, and behold, if there be good toward David, and I then send not unto thee, and show it thee, the Lord do so and much more to Jonathan. But if it please my father to do thee evil, then I will show it thee, and send thee away, that thou mayest go in peace, and the Lord be with thee, as he hath been with my father. And thou shalt not only while yet I live show me the kindness of the Lord, that I die not, but also thou shalt not cut off thy kindness from my house for ever. No, not when the Lord hath cut off the enemies of David, every one from the face of the earth.
So Jonathan made a covenant with the house of David, saying,
Let the Lord even require it at the hands of David's enemies.
And Jonathan caused David to swear again because he loved him, for he loved him as he loved his own soul. Then Jonathan said to David,
Tomorrow is the new moon, and thou shalt be missed, because thy seat will be empty. And when thou hast stayed 3 days, then thou shalt go down quickly, and come to the place where thou didst hide thyself when the business was in hand, and shalt remain by the stone easel. And I will shoot 3 arrows on the side thereof, as though I shot at a mark. And, behold, I will send a lad, saying, Go, find out the arrows. If I expressly say unto the lad, Behold, the arrows are on this side of thee, take them. Then come thou, for there is peace to thee, and no hurt, as the Lord liveth. But if I say to the young man, Behold, the arrows are beyond thee, go thy way, for the Lord hath sent thee away. And as touching the matter which thou and I have spoken of, behold, the Lord be between thee and me for ever.
So David hid himself in the field, and when the new moon was come, the king sat him down to eat meat. And the king sat upon his seat, as at other times, even upon a seat by the wall. And Jonathan arose, and Abner sat by Saul's side, and David's place was empty. Nevertheless, Saul spake not anything that day, for he thought,
Something hath befallen him. He is not clean. Surely he is not clean.
And it came to pass on the morrow, which was the second day of the month, that David's place was empty. And Saul said unto Jonathan his son,
Wherefore cometh not the son of Jesse to meat, neither yesterday nor today?
And Jonathan answered Saul,
David earnestly asked leave of me to go to Bethlehem. And he said, Let me go, I pray thee, for our family hath a sacrifice in the city, and my brother, he hath commanded me to be there. And now, if I have found favor in thine eyes, let me get away, I pray thee, and see my brethren. Therefore he cometh not unto the king's table.
Then Saul's anger was kindled against Jonathan, and he said unto him,
Thou son of the perverse, rebellious woman, do not I know that thou hast chosen the son of Jesse to thine own confusion, and unto the confusion of thy mother's nakedness? For as long as the son of Jesse liveth upon the ground, thou shalt not be established, nor thy kingdom. Wherefore now send and fetch him unto me, for he shall surely die.
And Jonathan answered Saul his father, and said unto him,
Wherefore shall he be slain? What hath he done?
And Saul cast a javelin at him to smite him, whereby Jonathan knew that it was determined of his father to slay David. So Jonathan arose from the table in fierce anger, and did eat no meat the second day of the month, for he was grieved for David because his father had done him shame. And it came to pass in the morning that Jonathan went out into the field at the time appointed with David, and a little lad with him. And he said unto his lad,
Run, find out the arrows which I shoot.
And as the lad ran, he shot an arrow beyond him. And when the lad was come to the place of the arrow which Jonathan had shot, Jonathan cried after the lad, and said,
Is not the arrow beyond thee?
And Jonathan cried after the lad,
Make speed, haste, stay not.
And Jonathan's lad gathered up the arrows and came to his master. But the lad knew not anything, only David and Jonathan knew the matter. And Jonathan gave his artillery unto his lad, and said unto him,
Go, carry them to the city.
As soon as the lad was gone, David arose out of a place toward the south, and fell on his face to the ground, and bowed himself three times. And they kissed one another, and wept with one another, until David exceeded. And Jonathan said to David,
Go in peace, for as much as we have both sworn of us in the name of the Lord, saying, The Lord be between me and thee, and between my seed and thy seed for ever.
And he arose and departed, and Jonathan went into the city. End of section 13. Section 14 of Dramatized Bible Passages from the Old Testament. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. The Story of David, Part 2, from 1 Samuel, Chapters 21 to 26, King James Version. Narrated by Beth Thomas.
David, read by Levi Throckmorton.
Ziphites, read by Lydia.
Saul, read by Larry Wilson.
Nabal, read by Eddie Shannon.
Men of Israel, servants, read by Catherine.
God, read by David Olson. Doeg, the Edomite, read by David Olson.
David's Men, read by Delta Pinrolis.
Ahimelech, read by E. Snow.
Achish, read by Sonia.
Abner, read by Thomas Peter.
Abigail, read by Esther Ben Simonides.
Then came David to Nob, to Ahimelech the priest. And Ahimelech was afraid at the meeting of David, and said unto him,
Why art thou alone, no man with thee?
And David said unto Ahimelech the priest,
The king hath commanded me a business, and hath said unto me, Let no man know anything of the business whereabout I send thee, and what I have commanded thee. And I have appointed my servants to such and such a place. Now therefore, what is under thine hand? Give me 5 loaves of bread in mine hand, or what there is present.
And the priest answered David, and said,
There is no common bread under mine hand, but there is hallowed bread, if the young men kept themselves at least from women.
And David answered the priest, and said unto him,
Of a truth, women have been kept from us about these 3 days, since I came out. And the vessels of the young men are holy, and the bread is in a manner common, yea, though it were sanctified this day in the vessel.
So the priest gave him hallowed bread, for there was no bread there but the shewbread, that was taken from before the Lord, to put hot bread in the day when it was taken away. Now a certain man of the servants of Saul was there that day, detained before the Lord, and his name was Doeg, an Edomite, the chiefest of the herdsmen that belonged to Saul. And David said unto Ahimelech,
And is there not here under thine hand spear or sword? For I have neither brought my sword nor my weapons with me, because the king's business required haste.
And the priest said,
The sword of Goliath the Philistine, whom thou slewest in the valley of Elah, behold, it is here wrapped in a cloth behind the ephod. If thou wilt take that, take it, for there is no other save that here.
And David said,
There is none like that. Give it to me.
And David arose and fled that day for fear of Saul, and went to Achish the king of Gath. And the servants of Achish said unto him,
Is not this David the king of the land? Did they not sing one to another of him in dances, saying, Saul hath slain his thousands, and David his 10,000s?
And David laid up these words in his heart, and was sore afraid of Achish the king of Gath. And he changed his behaviour before them, and feigned himself mad in their hands, and scrabbled on the doors of the gate, and let his spittle fall down upon his beard. Then said Achish unto his servants,
Lo, ye see the man is mad. Wherefore then have ye brought him to me? Have I need of madman, that ye have brought this fellow to play the madman in my presence? Shall this fellow come into my house?
David therefore departed thence, and escaped to the cave Adullam, and when his brethren and all his father's house heard it, they went down thither to him. And every one that was in distress, and every one that was in debt, and every one that was discontented, gathered themselves unto him. And he became a captain over them, and there were with him about 400 men. And David went thence to Mizpah of Moab, and he said unto the king of Moab,
Let my father and my mother, I pray thee, come forth, and be with you, till I know what God will do for me.
And he brought them before the king of Moab, and they dwelt with him all the while that David was in the hold. And the prophet Gad said unto David,
Abide not in the hold, depart, and get thee into the land of Judah.
Then David departed, and came into the forest of Harith. When Saul heard that David was discovered, and the men that were with him, now Saul abode in Gibeah, under a tree in Ramah, having his spear in his hand, and all his servants were standing about him. Then Saul said unto his servants that stood about him,
Hear now, ye Benjamites, will the son of Jesse give every one of you fields and vineyards, and make you all captains of thousands and captains of hundreds, that all of you have conspired against me, and there is none that showeth me that my son hath made a league with the son of Jesse, and there is none of you that is sorry for me, or showeth unto me that my son hath stirred up my servant against me, to lie in wait as at this day?
Then answered Doeg the Edomite, which was set over the servants of Saul, and said,
I saw the son of Jesse coming to Nob, to Ahimelech, the son of Ahitub, and he inquired of the Lord for him, and gave him victuals, and gave him the sword of Goliath the Philistine.
Then the king sent to call Ahimelech the priest, the son of Ahitub, and all his father's house, the priests that were in Nob. And they came, all of them, to the king. And Saul said,
Hear now, thou son of Ahitub.
And he answered,
I am here, my lord.
And Saul said unto him,
Why have ye conspired against me, thou and the son of Jesse, in that thou hast given him bread and a sword, and hast inquired of God for him, that he should rise against me to lie in wait as at this day?
Then Ahimelech answered the king and said,
And who is so faithful among all thy servants as David, which the king's son-in-law, and goeth thy bidding, and is honourable in thine house? Did I then begin to inquire of the Lord for him? Be it far from me, let not the king impute anything unto his servant, nor to all the house of my father, for thy servant knew nothing of all this, less or more.
And the king said,
Thou shalt surely die, Ahimelech, thou and all thy father's house.
And the king said unto the footmen that stood about him,
Turn and slay the priests of the Lord, because their hand also is with David, and because they knew when he fled, and did not show it to me.
But the servants of the king would not put forth their hand to fall upon the priests of the Lord. And the king said to Doeg,
Turn thou and fall upon the priests.
And Doeg the Edomite turned, and he fell upon the priests, and slew on that day 85 persons that did wear a linen ephod. And Nob, the city of the priests, smote he with the edge of the sword both men and women, children and sucklings, and oxen and asses and sheep, with the edge of the sword. And one of the sons of Ahimelech, the son of Ahitub, named Abiathar, escaped and fled after David. And Abiathar showed David that Saul had slain the Lord's priests. And David said unto Abiathar,
I knew it that day, when Doeg the Edomite was there, that he would surely tell Saul, I have occasioned the death of all the persons of thy father's house. Abide thou with me, fear not, for he that seeketh my life seeketh thy life. But with me thou shalt be in safeguard.
Then they told David, saying,
Behold, the Philistines fight against Keilah, and they rob the threshing floors.
Therefore David inquired of the Lord, saying,
Shall I go and smite these Philistines?
And the Lord said unto David,
Go and smite the Philistines, and save Keilah.
And David's men said unto him,
Behold, we be afraid here in Judah. How much more then if we come to Keilah against the armies of the Philistines?
Then David inquired of the Lord yet again, and the Lord answered him and said,
Arise, go down to Keilah, for I will deliver the Philistines into thine hand.
So David and his men went to Keilah, and fought with the Philistines, and brought away their cattle, and smote them with a great slaughter. So David saved the inhabitants of Keilah. And it came to pass, when Abiathar the son of Ahimelech fled to David to Keilah, that he came down with an ephod in his hand, and it was told Saul that David was come to Keilah. And Saul said,
God hath delivered him into mine hand, for he is shut in by entering into a town that hath gates and bars.
And Saul called all the people together to war, to go down to Keilah to besiege David and his men. And David knew that Saul secretly practiced mischief against him. And he said to Abiathar the priest,
Bring hither the ephod.
Then said David,
O Lord, God of Israel, thy servant hath certainly heard that Saul seeketh to come to Keilah to destroy the city for my sake. Will the men of Keilah deliver me up into his hand? Will Saul come down, as thy servant hath heard? O Lord God of Israel, I beseech thee, tell thy servant.
And the Lord said,
He will come down.
Then said David,
Will the men of Keilah deliver me and my men into the hand of Saul?
And the Lord said,
They will deliver thee up.
Then David and his men, which were about 600, arose and departed out of Keilah, and went whithersoever they could go. And it was told Saul that David was escaped from Keilah, and he forbare to go forth. And David abode in the wilderness in strongholds, and remained in a mountain in the wilderness of Ziph. And Saul sought him every day, but God delivered him not into his hand. And David saw that Saul had come out to seek his life. And David was in the wilderness of Ziph in a wood. And Jonathan, Saul's son, arose and went to David into the wood, and strengthened his hand in God. And he said unto him,
Fear not, for the hand of Saul my father shall not find thee, and thou shalt be king over Israel, and I shall be next unto thee, and that also Saul my father knoweth.
And they two made a covenant before the Lord. And David abode in the wood, and Jonathan went to his house. Then came up the Ziphites to Saul in Gibeah, saying,
Doth not David hide himself with us in strongholds in the wood, in the hill of Hachilah, which is on the south of Jeshimon? Now therefore, O king, come down according to all the desire of thy soul to come down, and our part shall be to deliver him into the king's hand.
And Saul said,
Blessed be ye of the Lord, for ye have compassion on me. Go, I pray you, prepare yet, and know and see his place where his haunt is, and who hath seen him there. For it is told me that he dealeth very subtly. See therefore, and take knowledge of all the lurking places where he hideth himself, and come again to me with the certainty, and I will go with you. And it shall come to pass, if he be in the land, that I will search him out throughout all the thousands of Judah.
And they arose and went to Ziph before Saul. But David and his men were in the wilderness of Maon, in the plain on the south of Jeshimon. Saul also and his men went to seek him. And they told David, wherefore he came down into a rock and abode in the wilderness of Maon. And when Saul heard that, he pursued after David in the wilderness of Maon. And Saul went on this side of the mountain, and David and his men on that side of the mountain. And David made haste to get away for fear of Saul, for Saul and his men compassed David and his men round about to take them. But there came a messenger unto Saul, saying,
Haste thee and come, for the Philistines have invaded the land.
Wherefore Saul returned from pursuing after David, and went against the Philistines. Therefore they called that place Selah Hamalekoth. And David went up from thence, and dwelt in the strongholds at En-Gedi. And it came to pass, when Saul was returned from following the Philistines, that it was told to him, saying,
Behold, David is in the wilderness of En-Gedi.
Then Saul took 3,000 chosen men out of all Israel, and went to seek David and his men upon the rocks of the wild goats. And he came to the sheepcotes by the way, where was a cave. And Saul went in to cover his feet, and David and his men remained in the sides of the cave. And the men of David said unto him,
Behold, the day of which the Lord has said unto thee, Behold, I will deliver thine enemy into thine hand, that thou mayest do to him as it shall seem good unto thee.
And David arose and cut off the skirt of Saul's robe privily. And it came to pass afterwards that David's heart smote him, because he had cut off Saul's skirt. And he said unto his men,
The Lord forbid that I should do this thing unto my master, the Lord's anointed, to stretch forth mine hand against him, seeing he is the anointed of the Lord.
So David stayed his servants with these words, and suffered them not to rise against Saul. But Saul rose up out of the cave and went on his way. David also arose afterward, and went out of the cave, and cried after Saul, saying,
My lord, the king!
And when Saul looked behind him, David stooped with his face to the earth, and bowed himself, and David said to Saul,
Wherefore hearest thou men's words, saying, Behold, David seeketh thy hurt? Behold, this day thine eyes have seen how that the Lord had delivered thee today into mine hand in the cave. And some bade me kill thee, but mine eye spared thee. And I said, I will not put forth mine hand against my Lord, for he is the Lord's anointed. Moreover, my father, see the skirt of thy robe in my hand. For in that I cut off the skirt of thy robe and killed thee not, know thou and see that there is neither evil nor transgression in mine hand, and I have not sinned against thee. Yet thou huntest my soul to take it. The Lord judge between me and thee, and the Lord avenge me of thee, but mine hand shall not be upon thee. As saith the proverb of the ancients, Wickedness proceedeth from the wicked, but mine hand shall not be upon thee. After whom is the king of Israel come out? After whom dost thou pursue? After a dead dog, after a flea. The Lord therefore be judge, and judge between me and thee. And see, and plead my cause, and deliver me out of thine hand.
And it came to pass, when David had made an end of speaking these words unto Saul, that Saul said,
Is this thy voice, my son David?
And Saul lifted up his voice and wept. And he said to David,
Thou art more righteous than I, for thou hast rewarded me good, whereas I have rewarded thee evil. And thou hast showed me this day how that thou hast dealt with me, forasmuch as when the Lord had delivered me into thine hand, thou killest me not. For if a man find his enemy, will he let him go well away? Wherefore the Lord reward thee good, for that thou hast done unto me this day. And now, behold, I know well that thou shalt surely be king, and that the kingdom of Israel shall be established in thine hand. Swear now therefore unto me by the Lord, that thou wilt not cut off my seed after me, and that thou wilt not destroy my name out of my father's house.
And David sware unto Saul, and Saul went home, but David and his men got them up unto the hold. And Samuel died, and all the Israelites were gathered together and lamented him, and buried him in his house at Ramah. And David arose and went down to the wilderness of Paran. And there was a man in Maon whose possessions were in Carmel, and the man was very great, and he had 3,000 sheep and 1,000 goats, and he was shearing his sheep in Carmel. Now the name of the man was Nabal, and the name of his wife Abigail. And she was a woman of good understanding and of a beautiful countenance. But the man was churlish and evil in his doings, and he was of the house of Caleb. And David heard in the wilderness that Nabal did shear his sheep. And David sent out 10 young men. And David said unto the young men,
Get you up to Carmel, and go to Nabal, and greet him in my name. And thus shall ye say to him that liveth in prosperity, Peace be both to thee, and peace be to thine house, and peace be unto all that thou hast. And now I have heard that thou hast shearers. Now thy shepherds which were with us, we hurt them not, neither was there aught missing unto them, all the while they were in Carmel. Ask thy young men, and they will shew thee. Wherefore let the young men find favour in thine eyes, for we come in a good day. Give, I pray thee, whatsoever cometh to thine hand unto thy servants, and to thy son David.
And when David's young men came, they spake to Nabal according to all the words in the name of David, and ceased. And Nabal answered David's servants, and said,
Who is David, and who is the son of Jesse? There be many servants nowadays that break away every man from his master. Shall I then take my bread, and my water, and my flesh that I have killed from my shearers, and give it unto men, whom I know not whence they be?
So David's young men turned their way and went again, and came and told him all those sayings. And David said unto his men,
Gird ye on every man his sword.
And they girded on every man his sword, and David also girded on his sword, and there went up after David about 400 men, and 200 abode by the stuff. But one of the young men told Abigail, Nabal's wife, saying,
Behold, David sent messengers out of the wilderness to salute our master, and he railed on them. But the men were very good unto us, and we were not hurt, neither missed we anything, as long as we were conversant with them, when we were in the fields. They were a wall unto us, both by night and day, all the while we were with them keeping the sheep. Now, therefore, know and consider what thou wilt do, for evil is determined against our master, and against all his household. For he is such a son of Belial, that a man cannot speak to him.
Then Abigail made haste, and took 200 loaves, and 2 bottles of wine, and 5 sheep ready dressed, and 5 measures of parched corn, and 100 clusters of raisins, and 200 cakes of figs, and laid them on asses. And she said unto her servants,
Go on before me. Behold, I come after you.
But she told not her husband Nabal. And it was so, as she rode on the ass, that she came down by the covert on the hill, and behold, David and his men came down against her, and she met them. Now David had said,
Surely in vain have I kept all that this fellow hath in the wilderness, so that nothing was missed of all that pertained unto him, and he hath requited me evil for good. So and more also do God unto the enemies of David, if I leave of all that pertain to him by the morning light any that pisseth against the wall.
And when Abigail saw David, she hasted, and lighted off the ass, and fell before David on her face, and bowed herself to the ground, and fell at his feet, and said,
Upon me, my lord, upon me let this iniquity be. And let thine handmaid, I pray thee, speak in thine audience, and hear the words of thine handmaid. Let not, my lord, I pray thee, regard this man of Belial, even Nabal, for as his name is, so is he. Nabal is his name, and folly is with him. But I, thine handmaid, saw not the young men of my lord, whom thou didst send. Now therefore, my lord, as the Lord liveth, and as thy soul liveth, seeing the Lord hath withholden thee from coming to shed blood, and from avenging thyself with thine own hand, let now thine enemies, and they that seek evil to my lord, be as Nabal. And now this blessing which thine handmaid hath brought unto my lord, let it even be given unto the young men that follow my lord. I pray thee forgive the trespass of thine handmaid, for the Lord will certainly make my lord a sure house, because my lord fighteth the battles of the Lord, and evil hath not been found in thee all thy days. Yet a man is risen to pursue thee, and to seek thy soul. But the soul of my lord shall be bound in the bundle of life with the Lord thy God, and the souls of thine enemies, them shall he sling out, as out of the middle of the sling. And it shall come to pass, when the Lord shall have done to my lord according to all the good that he hath spoken concerning thee, and shall have appointed thee ruler over Israel, that this shall be no grief unto thee, nor offence of heart unto my lord, either that thou hast shed blood causeless, or that my lord hath avenged himself. But when the Lord shall have dealt well with my lord, then remember thine handmaid.
And David said to Abigail,
Blessed be the Lord God of Israel, which sent thee this day to meet me. And blessed be thy advice, and blessed be thou, which hast kept me this day from coming to shed blood, and from avenging myself with mine own hand. For in very deed, as the Lord God of Israel liveth, which hath kept me back from hurting thee, except thou hadst hasted and come to meet me, surely there had not been left unto Nabal by the morning light any that pisseth against the wall.
So David received of her hand that which she had brought him, and said unto her,
Go up in peace to thine house. See, I have hearkened to thy voice, and have accepted thy person.
And Abigail came to Nabal, and behold, he held a feast in his house like the feast of a king. And Nabal's heart was merry within him, for he was very drunken. Wherefore she told him nothing, less or more, until the morning light. But it came to pass in the morning, when the wine was gone out of Nabal, and his wife had told him these things, that his heart died within him, and he became as a stone. And it came to pass about 10 days after, that the Lord smote Nabal, and he died. And when David heard that Nabal was dead, he said,
Blessed be the Lord, that hath pleaded the cause of my reproach from the hand of Nabal, and hath kept his servant from evil. For the Lord hath returned the wickedness of Nabal upon his own head.
And David sent and communed with Abigail to take her to him to wife. And when the servants of David were come to Abigail to Carmel, they spake unto her, saying,
David sent us unto thee, to take thee to him to wife.
And she arose, and bowed herself on her face to the earth, and said,
Behold, let thine handmaid be a servant to wash the feet of the servants of my lord.
And Abigail hasted and arose, and rode upon an ass with 5 damsels of hers that went after her, and she went after the messengers of David and became his wife. David also took Ahinoam of Jezreel, and they were also both of them his wives. But Saul had given Michal his daughter, David's wife, to Phalti the son of Laish, which was of Galim. And the Ziphites came unto Saul to Gibeah, saying,
Doth not David hide himself in the hill of Hachilah, which is before Jeshimon?
Then Saul arose and went down to the wilderness of Ziph, having 3,000 chosen men of Israel with him, to seek David in the wilderness of Ziph. And Saul pitched in the hill of Hachilah, which is before Jeshimon, by the way. But David abode in the wilderness, and he saw that Saul came after him into the wilderness. David therefore sent out spies, and understood that Saul was come in very deed. And David arose and came to the place where Saul had pitched. And David beheld the place where Saul lay, and Abner the son of Ner, the captain of his host, and Saul lay in the trench, and the people pitched round about him. Then answered David, and said to Ahimelech the Hittite, and to Abishai the son of Zeruiah, brother to Joab, saying,
Who will go down with me to Saul to the camp?
I will go down with thee.
So David and Abishai came to the people by night, and behold, Saul lay sleeping within the trench, and his spear stuck in the ground at his bolster. But Abner and the people lay round about him. Then said Abishai to David,
God hath delivered thine enemy into thine hand this day. Now therefore let me smite him, I pray thee, with the spear, even to the earth at once, and I will not smite him the second time.
And David said to Abishai,
Destroy him not, for who can stretch forth his hand against the Lord's anointed, and be guiltless?
David said furthermore,
As the Lord liveth, the Lord shall smite him. Or his day shall come to die, or he shall descend into battle and perish. The Lord forbid that I should stretch forth mine hand against the Lord's anointed. But, I pray thee, take thou now the spear that is at his bolster, and the cruse of water, and let us go.
So David took the spear and the cruse of water from Saul's bolster, and they got them away, and no man saw it nor knew it, neither awaked. For they were all asleep, because a deep sleep from the Lord was fallen upon them. Then David went over to the other side, and stood on the top of a hill afar off, a great space being between them. And David cried to the people and to Abner the son of Ner, saying,
Answerest thou not, Abner?
Then Abner answered and said,
Who art thou that criest to the king?
And David said to Abner,
Art not thou a valiant man? And who is like to thee in Israel? Wherefore then hast thou not kept thy lord the king? For there came one of the people in to destroy the king thy lord. This thing is not good that thou hast done. As the Lord liveth, ye are worthy to die, because ye have not kept your master, the Lord's anointed. And now see where the king's spear is, and the cruse of water that was at his bolster.
And Saul knew David's voice, and said,
Is this thy voice, my son David?
And David said,
It is my voice, my lord, O king.
And he said,
Wherefore doth my lord thus pursue after his servant? For what have I done, or what evil is in mine hand? Now therefore, I pray thee, let my lord the king hear the words of his servant. If the Lord have stirred thee up against me, let him accept an offering. But if they be the children of men, cursed be they before the Lord. For they have driven me out this day from abiding in the inheritance of the Lord, saying, Go, serve other gods. Now therefore, let not my blood fall to the earth before the face of the Lord. For the king of Israel is come out to seek a flea, as when one doth hunt a partridge in the mountains.
Then said Saul,
I have sinned. Return, my son David, for I will no more do thee harm, because my soul was precious in thine eyes this day. Behold, I have played the fool, and have erred exceedingly.
And David answered and said,
Behold, the king's spear, and let one of the young men come over and fetch it. The Lord render to every man his righteousness and his faithfulness, for the Lord delivered thee into my hand today, but I would not stretch forth mine hand against the Lord's anointed. And behold, as thy life was much set by this day in mine eyes, so let my life be much set by in the eyes of the Lord, and let him deliver me out of all tribulation.
Then said Saul to David,
Blessed be thou, my son David. Thou shalt both do great things, and also shall still prevail.
So David went on his way, and Saul returned to his place. End of section 14. Section 15 of Dramatized Bible Passages from the Old Testament. This is a LibriVox recording. All LibriVox recordings are in the public domain. For more information or to volunteer, please visit LibriVox.org. The Story of David, Part 3, from 2 Samuel, Chapters 5 to 12, King James Version. Narrated by Beth Thomas.
Seba, read by Christine G.
Uriah, read by James Curran.
Princes of Ammon, read by Marianne.
Nathan, read by Anne Finwin.
Michael, read by Esther and Simonides.
Mephibosheth, read by Lydia.
Men of Israel, read by Catherine.
Joab, read by Thomas Peter.
Jebusites, read by Delde Pinoles.
God, read by David Olson.
David, read by Levi Throckmorton.
Bathsheba, read by Bethany Baldwin.
Then came all the tribes of Israel to David unto Hebron, and spake, saying,
Behold, we are thy bone and thy flesh. Also in time past, when Saul was king over us, thou wast he that leddest out and broughtest in Israel. And the Lord said to thee, Thou shalt feed my people Israel, and thou shalt be a captain over Israel.
So all the elders of Israel came to the king to Hebron, and King David made a league with them in Hebron before the Lord, and they anointed David king over Israel. David was 30 years old when he began to reign, and he reigned 40 years. In Hebron he reigned over Judah 7 years and 6 months, and in Jerusalem he reigned 33 years over all Israel and Judah. And the king and his men went to Jerusalem unto the Jebusites, the inhabitants of the land, which spake unto David, saying,
Except thou take away the blind and the lame, thou shalt not come in hither.
Thinking,
David cannot come in hither.
Nevertheless, David took the stronghold of Zion, the same is the city of David. And David said on that day,
Whosoever getteth up to the gutter, and smiteth the Jebusites, and the lame, and the blind, that are hated of David's soul, he shall be chief and captain.
Wherefore they said,
The blind and the lame shall not come into the house.
So David dwelt in the fort, and called it the city of David. And David built round about from Millo and inward. And David went on and grew great, and the Lord God of hosts was with him. And Hiram, king of Tyre, sent messengers to David, and cedar trees, and carpenters, and masons, and they built David a house. And David perceived that the Lord had established him king over Israel, and that he had exalted his kingdom for his people Israel's sake. And David took him more concubines and wives out of Jerusalem, after he was come from Hebron. And there were yet sons and daughters born to David. And these be the names of those that were born unto him in Jerusalem, Shammua, and Shobab, and Nathan, and Solomon, Ibhar also, and Elishua, and Nepheg, and Japhia, and Elishama, and Eliada, and Eliphelet. But when the Philistines heard that they had anointed David king over Israel, all the Philistines came up to seek David, and David heard of it, and went down to the hold. The Philistines also came, and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim. And David inquired of the Lord, saying,
Shall I go up to the Philistines? Wilt thou deliver them into mine hand?
And the Lord said unto David,
Go up, for I will doubtless deliver the Philistines into thine hand.
And David came to Baal-perazim, and David smote them there, and said,
The Lord hath broken forth upon mine enemies before me, as the breach of waters.
Therefore he called the name of that place Baal-perazim. And there they left their images, and David and his men burned them. And the Philistines came up yet again, and spread themselves in the valley of Rephaim. And when David inquired of the Lord, he said,
Thou shalt not go up, but fetch a compass behind them, and come upon them over against the mulberry trees. And let it be, when thou hearest the sound of a going in the tops of the mulberry trees, that then thou shalt bestir thyself. For then shall the Lord go out before thee, to smite the host of the Philistines.
And David did so, as the Lord had commanded him, and smote the Philistines from Geba until thou come to Gaza. Again David gathered together all the chosen men of Israel, 30,000. And David arose and went with all the people that were with him from Baal of Judah, to bring up from thence the ark of God, whose name is called by the name of the Lord of hosts that dwelleth between the cherubims. And they set the ark of God upon a new cart, and brought it out of the house of Abinadab that was in Gibeah, And Uzzah and Ahio, the sons of Abinadab, drave the new cart, and they brought it out of the house of Abinadab, which was at Gibeah, accompanying the ark of God. And Ahio went before the ark, and David and all the house of Israel played before the Lord on all manner of instruments made of fir wood, even on harps and psalteries, and on timbrels, and on cornets, and on cymbals. And when they came to Nacon's threshing floor, Uzzah put forth his hand to the ark of God, and took hold of it, for the oxen shook it. And the anger of the Lord was kindled against Uzzah, and God smote him there for his error, and there he died by the ark of God. And David was displeased, because the Lord had made a breach upon Uzzah, and he called the name of the place Perazuzah to this day. And David was afraid of the Lord that day, and said,
How shall the ark of the Lord come to me?
So David would not remove the ark of the Lord unto him into the city of David. But David carried it aside into the house of Obededom the Gittite. And the ark of the Lord continued in the house of Obededom the Gittite 3 months, and the Lord blessed Obededom and all his household. And it was told King David, saying,
The Lord hath blessed the house of Obededom and all that pertaineth unto him, because of the ark of God.
So David went and brought up the ark of God from the house of Obededom into the city of David with gladness. And it was so, that when they that bare the ark of the Lord had gone 6 paces, he sacrificed oxen and fatlings. And David danced before the Lord with all his might, and David was girded with a linen ephod. So David and all the house of Israel brought up the ark of the Lord with shouting and with the sound of the trumpet. And as the ark of the Lord came into the city of David, Michal, Saul's daughter, looked through a window, and saw King David leaping and dancing before the Lord, and she despised him in her heart. And they brought in the ark of the Lord, and set it in his place, in the midst of the tabernacle that David had pitched for it. And David offered burnt offerings and peace offerings before the Lord. And as soon as David had made an end of offering burnt offerings and peace offerings, he blessed the people in the name of the Lord of hosts. And he dealt among all the people, even among the whole multitude of Israel, as well to the women as men, to every one a cake of bread and a good piece of flesh and a flagon of wine. So all the people departed, every one to his house. Then David returned to bless his household, and Michal the daughter of Saul came out to meet David, and said,
How glorious was the king of Israel today, who uncovered himself today in the eyes of the handmaids of his servant, as one of the vain fellows shamelessly uncovereth himself.
And David said unto Michal,
It was before the Lord, which chose me before thy father, and before all his house, to appoint me ruler over the people of the Lord, over Israel. Therefore will I play before the Lord. And I will yet be more vile than thus, and will be base in mine own sight. And of the maidservants which thou hast spoken of them shall I be had in honour.
Therefore Michal the daughter of Saul had no child unto the day of her death. And it came to pass, when the king sat in his house, and the Lord had given him rest round about from all his enemies, that the king said unto Nathan the prophet,
See now, I dwell in a house of cedar, but the ark of God dwelleth within curtains.
And Nathan said to the king,
Go, do all that is in thine heart, for the Lord is with thee.
And it came to pass that night, that the word of the Lord came unto Nathan, saying,
Go and tell my servant David, Thus saith the Lord, Shalt thou build me a house for me to dwell in? Whereas I have not dwelt in any house since the time that I brought up the children of Israel out of Egypt, even to this day, but have walked in a tent and in a tabernacle. In all the places wherein I have walked, with all the children of Israel, spake I a word with any of the tribes of Israel, whom I commanded to feed my people Israel, saying, Why build ye not me a house of cedar? Now therefore so shalt thou say unto my servant David, Thus saith the Lord of hosts, I took thee from the sheepcote, from following the sheep, to be ruler over my people, over Israel. And I was with thee whithersoever thou wentest, and have cut off all thine enemies out of thy sight, and have made thee a great name, like unto the name of the great men that are in the earth. Moreover, I will appoint a place for my people Israel, and will plant them, that they may dwell in a place of their own, and move no more. Neither shall the children of wickedness afflict them any more, as before time. And as since that time that I commanded judges to be over my people Israel, and have caused thee to rest from all thine enemies. Also the Lord telleth thee that he will make thee an house, and when thy days be fulfilled, and thou shalt sleep with thy fathers, I will set up thy seed after thee, which shall proceed out of thy bowels, and I will establish his kingdom. He shall build a house for my name, and I will establish the throne of his kingdom forever. I will be his father, and he shall be my son. If he commit iniquity, I will chasten him with the rod of men, and with the stripes of the children of men. But my mercy shall not depart away from him, as I took it from Saul, whom I put away before thee. And thine house and thy kingdom shall be established for ever before thee. Thy throne shall be established for ever.
According to all these words, and according to all this vision, so did Nathan speak unto David. Then went King David in, and sat before the Lord, and he said,
Who am I, O Lord God, and what is my house that thou hast brought me hitherto? And this was yet a small thing in thy sight, O Lord God, but thou hast spoken also of thy servant's house for a great while to come. And is this the manner of man, O Lord God? And what can David say more unto thee? For thou, Lord God, knowest thy servant. For thy word's sake, and according to thine own heart, hast thou done all these great things to make thy servant know them. Wherefore thou art great, O Lord God, for there is none like thee, neither is there any God beside thee, according to all that we have heard with our ears. And what one nation in the earth is like thy people, even like Israel, whom God went to redeem for a people to himself, and to make him a name, and to do for you great things and terrible, for thy land, before thy people, which thou redeemedst to thee from Egypt, from the nations and their gods. For thou hast confirmed to thyself thy people Israel to be a people unto thee for ever, and thou, Lord, art become their God. And now, O Lord God, the word that thou hast spoken concerning thy servant, and concerning his house, establish it for ever, and do as thou hast said. And let thy name be magnified for ever, saying, The Lord of hosts is the God over Israel. And let the house of thy servant David be established before thee. For thou, O Lord of hosts, God of Israel, hast revealed to thy servant, saying, I will build thee an house. Therefore hath thy servant found in his heart to pray this prayer unto thee. And now, O Lord God, thou art that God, and thy words be true, and thou hast promised this goodness unto thy servant. Therefore now, let it please thee to bless the house of thy servant, that it may continue for ever before thee. For thou, O Lord God, hast spoken it, and with thy blessing let the house of thy servant be blessed for ever.
And after this it came to pass that David smote the Philistines and subdued them. And David took Methegammah out of the hand of the Philistines, and he smote Moab, and measured them with a line, casting them down to the ground. Even with two lines measured he to put to death, and with one full line to keep alive. And so the Moabites became David's servants, and brought gifts. David smote also Hadadezer, the son of Rehob, king of Zobah, as he went to recover his border at the river Euphrates. And David took from him 1,000 chariots, and 700 horsemen, and 20,000 footmen. And David hoffed all the chariot horses, but reserved them for 100 chariots. And when the Syrians of Damascus came to succour Hadadezer, king of Zobah, David slew of the Syrians 22,000 men. Then David put the garrisons in Syria of Damascus, and the Syrians became servants to David and brought gifts. And the Lord preserved David whithersoever he went. And David took the shields of gold that were on the servants of Hadadezer, and brought them to Jerusalem. And from Beta, and from Berothai, cities of Hadadezer, King David took exceeding much brass. When Toi, king of Hamath, heard that David had smitten all the host of Hadadezer, then Toi sent Joram his son unto King David, to salute him and to bless him, because he had fought against Hadadezer and smitten him, for Hadadezer had wars with Toi. And Joram brought with him vessels of silver and vessels of gold and vessels of brass, which also King David did dedicate unto the Lord, with the silver and gold that he had dedicated of all nations which he subdued, of Syria and of Moab, and of the children of Ammon, and of the Philistines, and of Amalek, and of the spoil of Hadadezer, son of Rehob, king of Zobah. And David gat him a name when he returned from smiting of the Syrians in the Valley of Salt, being 18,000 men. And he put garrisons in Edom. Throughout all Edom put he garrisons, and all they of Edom became David's servants. And the Lord preserved David whithersoever he went. And David reigned over all Israel, and David executed judgment and justice unto all his people. And Joab the son of Zeruiah was over the host, and Jehoshaphat the son of Ahilud was recorder, and Zadok the son of Ahitub, and Ahimelech the son of Abiathar were the priests, and Sariah was the scribe, and Benaiah the son of Jehoiada was over both the Cherethites and the Pelethites, and David's sons were chief rulers. And David said,
Is there yet any that is left of the house of Saul, that I may shew him kindness for Jonathan's sake?
And there was of the house of Saul a servant whose name was Ziba. And when they had called him unto David, the king said unto him,
Art thou Ziba?
And he said,
Thy servant is he.
And the king said,
Is there not yet any of the house of Saul, that I may shew the kindness of God unto him?
And Ziba said unto the king,
Jonathan hath yet a son, which is lame on his feet.
And the king said unto him,
Where is he?
And Ziba said unto the king,
Behold, he is in the house of Machir, the son of Amiel, in Lodabar.
Then King David sent, and fetched him out of the house of Machir, the son of Amiel, from Lodabar. Now when Mephibosheth, the son of Jonathan, the son of Saul, was come unto David, he fell on his face and did reverence. And David said,
Mephibosheth.
And he answered,
Behold thy servant.
And David said unto him,
Fear not, for I will surely shew thee kindness for Jonathan thy father's sake, and will restore thee all the land of Saul thy father, and thou shalt eat bread at my table continually.
And he bowed himself and said,
What is thy servant, that thou shouldest look upon such a dead dog as I am?
Then the king called to Ziba, Saul's servant, and said unto him,
I have given unto thy master's son all that pertained to Saul and to all his house. Thou therefore, and thy sons, and thy servants, shall till the land for him, and thou shalt bring in the fruits, that thy master's son may have food to eat. But Mephibosheth, thy master's son, shall eat bread alway at my table.
Now Ziba had 15 sons and 20 servants. Then said Ziba unto the king,
According to all that my lord the king hath commanded his servant, so shall thy servant do.
As for Mephibosheth,
said the king,
he shall eat at my table as one of the king's sons.
And Mephibosheth had a young son whose name was Micah, and all that dwelt in the house of Ziba were servants unto Mephibosheth. So Mephibosheth dwelt in Jerusalem, and he did eat continually at the king's table, and was lame on both his feet. And it came to pass after this, that the king of the children of Ammon died, and Hanun his son reigned in his stead. Then said David,
I will shew kindness unto Hanun the son of Nahash, as his father shewed kindness unto me.
And David sent to comfort him by the hand of his servants for his father. And David's servants came into the land of the children of Ammon. And the princes of the children of Ammon said unto Hanun their lord,
Thinkest thou that David doth honour thy father, that he hath sent comforters unto thee? Hath not David rather sent his servants unto thee, to search the city, and spy it out, and to overthrow it?
Wherefore Hanun took David's servants, and shaved off the one half of their beards, and cut off their garments in the middle, even to their buttocks, and sent them away. When they told it unto David, he sent to meet them, because the men were greatly ashamed. And the king said,
Tarry at Jericho until your beards be grown, and then return.
And when the children of Ammon saw that they stank before David, the children of Ammon sent and hired the Syrians of Bethrehob and the Syrians of Zobah, 20,000 footmen, and of King Maacah 1,000 men, and of Ishtob 12,000 men. And when David heard of it, he sent Joab and all the host of the mighty men. And the children of Ammon came out and put the battle in array at the entering in of the gate. And the Syrians of Zobah and of Rehob and Ishtob and Maacah were by themselves in the field. When Joab saw that the front of the battle was against him before and behind, he chose of all the choice men of Israel and put them in array against the Syrians. And the rest of the people he delivered into the hand of Abishai his brother, that he might put them in array against the children of Ammon. And he said,
If the Syrians be too strong for me, then thou shalt help me. But if the children of Ammon be too strong for thee, then I will come and help thee. Be of good courage, and let us play the men for our people, and for the cities of our God, and the Lord do that which seemeth him good.
And Joab drew nigh, and all the people that were with him, unto the battle against the Syrians, and they fled before him. And when the children of Ammon saw that the Syrians were fled, then fled they also before Abishai, and entered into the city. So Joab returned from the children of Ammon, and came to Jerusalem. And when the Syrians saw that they were smitten before Israel, they gathered themselves together. And Hadarezer sent, and brought out the Syrians that were beyond the river. And they came to Hillam, and Shobach, the captain of the host of Hadarezer, went before them. And when it was told David, he gathered all Israel together, and passed over Jordan, and came to Hillam. And the Syrians set themselves in array against David, and fought with him. And the Syrians fled before Israel. And David slew the men of 700 chariots of the Syrians, and 40,000 horsemen, and smote Shobach, the captain of their host, who died there. And when all the kings that were servants to Hadarezer saw that they were smitten before Israel, they made peace with Israel and served them. So the Syrians feared to help the children of Ammon any more. And it came to pass, after the year was expired, at the time when kings go forth to battle, that David sent Joab and his servants with him, and all Israel, and they destroyed the children of Ammon, and besieged Rabbah. But David tarried still at Jerusalem. And it came to pass in an evening tide that David arose from off his bed and walked upon the roof of the king's house, and from the roof he saw a woman washing herself, and the woman was very beautiful to look upon. And David sent and inquired after the woman, and one said,
Is not this Bathsheba, the daughter of Eliam, the wife of Uriah, the Hittite?
And David sent messengers and took her. And she came in unto him, and he lay with her, for she was purified from her uncleanness, and she returned unto her house. And the woman conceived, and sent and told David, and said,
I am with child.
And David sent to Joab, saying,
Send me Uriah the Hittite.
And Joab sent Uriah to David. And when Uriah was come unto him, David demanded of him how Joab did, and how the people did, and how the war prospered. And David said to Uriah,
Go down to thy house, and wash thy feet.
And Uriah departed out of the king's house, and there followed him a mess of meat from the king. But Uriah slept at the door of the king's house with all the servants of his lord, and went not down to his house. And when they had told David, saying,
Uriah went not down unto his house,
David said unto Uriah,
Camest thou not from thy journey? Why then didst thou not go down unto thine house?
And Uriah said unto David,
The ark, and Israel, and Judah, abide in tents. And my lord Joab, and the servants of my lord, are encamped in the open field. Shall I then go into mine house, to eat and to drink, and to lie with my wife? As thou livest, and as thou so liveth, I will not do this thing.
And David said to Uriah,
Tarry here today also, and tomorrow I will let thee depart.
So Uriah abode in Jerusalem that day and the morrow. And when David had called him, he did eat and drink before him, and he made him drunk. And at even he went out to lie on his bed with the servants of his lord, but went not down to his house. And it came to pass in the morning that David wrote a letter to Joab, and sent it by the hands of Uriah. And he wrote in the letter, saying,
Set ye Uriah in the forefront of the hottest battle, and retire ye from him, that he may be smitten and die.
And it came to pass, when Joab observed the city, that he assigned Uriah unto a place where he knew that valiant men were. And the men of the city went out, and fought with Joab, and there fell some of the people of the servants of David, and Uriah the Hittite died also. Then Joab sent, and told David all the things concerning the war, and charged the messenger, saying,
When thou hast made an end of telling the matters of the war unto the king, and if so be that the king's wrath arise, and he say unto thee, Wherefore approached ye so nigh unto the city when ye did fight? Knew ye not that they would shoot from the wall? Who smote Abimelech the son of Drubasheth? Did not a woman cast a piece of a millstone upon him from the wall, that he died in Thebes? Why went ye nigh the wall?
So the messenger went, and came and showed David all that Joab had sent him for. And the messenger said unto David,
Surely the men prevailed against us, and came out unto us into the field, and we were upon them even unto the entering of the gate. And the shooters shot from the wall upon thy servants, and some of the king's servants be dead. And thy servant Uriah the Hittite is dead also.
Then David said unto the messenger,
Thus shalt thou say unto Joab, Let not this thing displease thee, for the sword devoureth one as well as another. Make thy battle more strong against the city, and overthrow it, and encourage thou him.
And when the wife of Uriah heard that Uriah her husband was dead, she mourned for her husband. And when the morning was past, David sent and fetched her to his house, and she became his wife, and bare him a son. But the thing that David had done displeased the Lord. And the Lord sent Nathan unto David, and he came unto him, and said unto him,
There were two men in one city, the one rich, and the other poor. The rich man had exceeding many flocks and herds, but the poor man had nothing, save one little ewe lamb, which he had brought and nourished up, and it grew up together with him and with his children. It did eat of his own meat, and drank of his own cup, and lay in his bosom, and was unto him as a daughter. And there came a traveller unto the rich man, and he spared to take of his own flock, and of his own herd, to dress for the wayfaring man that was come unto him, but took the poor man's lamb, and dressed it for the man that was come to him.
And David's anger was greatly kindled against the man, and he said to Nathan,
As the Lord liveth, the man that hath done this thing shall surely die, and he shall restore the lamb fourfold, because he did this thing, and because he had no pity.
And Nathan said to David,
Thou art the man. Thus saith the Lord God of Israel, I anointed thee king over Israel, and I delivered thee out of the hand of Saul, and I gave thee thy master's house, and thy master's wives into thy bosom, and gave thee the house of Israel and of Judah. And if that had been too little, I would moreover have given unto thee such and such things. Wherefore hast thou despised the commandment of the Lord to do evil in his sight? Thou hast killed Uriah the Hittite with the sword, and hast taken his wife to be thy wife, and hast slain him with the sword of the children of Ammon. Now therefore, the sword shall never depart from thine house, because thou hast despised me, and taken the wife of Uriah the Hittite to be thy wife. Thus saith the Lord, Behold, I will raise up evil against thee out of thine own house, and I will take thy wives before thine eyes, and give them unto thy neighbor, and he shall lie with thy wives in the sight of the sun. For thou didst it secretly. But I will do this thing before all Israel, and before the sun.
And David said unto Nathan,
I have sinned against the Lord.
And Nathan said unto David,
The Lord also hath put away thy sin. Thou shalt not die. Howbeit, because by this deed thou hast given great occasion to the enemies of the Lord to blaspheme, the child also that is born unto thee shall surely die.
And Nathan departed unto his house, and the Lord struck the child that Uriah's wife bare unto David, and it was very sick. David therefore besought God for the child, and David fasted, and went in and lay all night upon the earth. And the elders of his house arose and went to him to raise him up from the earth, but he would not, neither did he eat bread with them. And it came to pass on the seventh day that the child died. And the servants of David feared to tell him that the child was dead, for they said,
Behold, while the child was yet alive, we spake unto him, and he would not hearken unto our voice. How will he then vex himself, if we tell him that the child is dead?
But when David saw that his servants whispered, David perceived that the child was dead. Therefore David said unto his servants,
Is the child dead?
And they said,
He is dead.
Then David arose from the earth, and washed, and anointed himself, and changed his apparel, and came into the house of the Lord, and worshipped. Then he came to his own house, and when he required, they set bread before him, and he did eat. Then said his servants unto him,
What thing is this that thou hast done? Thou didst fast and weep for the child, while it was alive, but when the child was dead, thou didst rise and eat bread.
And he said,
While the child was yet alive, I fasted and wept. For I said, Who can tell whether God will be gracious to me, that the child may live? But now he is dead. Wherefore should I fast? Can I bring him back again? I shall go to him, but he shall not return to me.
And David comforted Bathsheba his wife, and went in unto her, and lay with her, and she bare a son. And he called his name Solomon, and the Lord loved him. And he sent by the hand of Nathan the prophet, and he called his name Jedidiah, because of the Lord. And Joab fought against Rabbah of the children of Ammon, and took the royal city. And Joab sent messengers to David, and said,
I have fought against Rabbah, and have taken the city of waters. Now therefore gather the rest of the people together, and encamp against the city, and take it, lest I take the city, and it be called after my name.
And David gathered all the people together, and went to Rabbah, and fought against it, and took it. And he took their king's crown from off his head, the weight whereof was a talent of gold with the precious stones, and it was set on David's head, and he brought forth the spoil of the city in great abundance. And he brought forth the people that were therein, and put them under saws, and under harrows of iron, and under axes of iron, and made them pass through the brick kiln, and thus did he unto all the cities of the children of Ammon. So David and all the people returned unto Jerusalem. End of section 15. End of the story of David.